straight path. I wonder where this goes. Let's find out.
What are you doing? This is private property. You're trespassing. Get out right now.
Yikes. I gotta get out of here. God, it has to hit it. Okay, let's see. How do you start?
I don't know.
How did she get away? That four-wheeler must have had a super speed that I didn't even know about. I'm getting my drone and I'm gonna catch her with that. This drone will not catch her. That way, I'll just get her from above and it'll be a whole lot easier. Don't move.
Wait.
Don't move.
You're good to go, but you need to take it easy.
Okay, thank you.
It's day 60 looking for the man who shot me. So far, I've narrowed it down to his house. So all we have to do is get revenge.
Finally made it in. Let's shut this door so nobody can follow you.
Now, while we're in here, let's look around.
Bunch of books. He needs something that I can use against him. What's this? Man, wish I could figure out what this does furthermore, so I could get more powers for it.
This is a message for all personnel entering the dungeon. I congratulate you on your success so far. But that ends today. As of right now, you
in the booby traps.
If you hold the power, we'll be safe here, and we'll never leave. No one will hear.
Yeah, right. I'm not staying in this house forever. I'm getting out of here. And I don't believe him. There are no booby traps in this place.
I'm gonna go home.
Who is this girl? And how did she find my lair? And most importantly, how did she know about the Orb of Power? I'll find her, and it'll be the end of her. How is this even possible? The Orb of Power goes away right before I'm ready to launch my secret weapon. How did she even know about that? Or did she? Is this just some random person that just happens to be driving by? Nah, there's no way. She had to have known. There's no other way.
Yeah, I see you going through my house. And I know what you've stolen. There's one room that I'm glad you didn't go in. Because I know you didn't notice this, but I have two powers. Two orbs of power. And you've only stolen the least powerful one.
Those orbs of power are risky business. And before I go and inject myself with that much power and possibly die, I'm going to send my drone at her house because I found her location. And I'm going to blow up her house on my computer using my drone. Now where's she going to go? Where is she going to turn? Dang, that drone is powerful. Ever since I put it with the Orb of Power, it's just unbelievable how powerful it is. Since I blew up her house, she's gonna have to go into hiding. I suspect she'll just find some little shack somewhere to live in for right now. But with all that power that she now carries, she's gonna have a lot of questions, and she's gonna be very easy to spot. So I'll be watching, and I'll be waiting until she makes a mistake, and then I'll get her.
Can't make it to my house because he destroyed it. So now I just have to stay here and it'll just have to do for now. But yeah, basically he destroyed my house. So I just have to stay in this little area right here
for now, until I can find something better.
I wonder if I could sell this. It's gotta be pretty valuable or worth some money because they had all those booby traps protecting it, so it has to mean something. But I just don't know what.
I gotta figure out how this works.
Well, I wonder what will happen if I touch it. I think I'm absorbing it. Okay, now I've taken all the power from it.
Useless.
Whoa! That is insane. What limits do I even have? There's this guy named Kevin Baxter, and he does studies on powerful relics and magical objects, so I wonder if he can help me. I could go to the library and research him.
I'm glad that the library has this free access for a computer. Let's look it up. Okay, let's see. Magic. Right here it says that this is the study of magic, and in order to do that, we have to go talk to this guy. Him. Kevin Baxter. I'll find him. It says right here he lives at 357 Sycamore Street.
357 Sycamore Street. Search. Hey, look, it's right here. Looks like it's going to take about 30 minutes to get there by car. Fortunately, I don't have a car, but I know someone who does. Hey, what's up, Hannah? Yeah, what about you? Mm-hmm. So do you think that you could come pick me up at the library and take me somewhere? Okay, yeah, cool. Okay, see you in a minute. Bye. All right, she's coming to get me.
Thanks for the ride. Thanks for the ride, Hannah. I really needed to get this done. Thanks again. Bye.
Hey, I scheduled a meeting with Kevin Baxter, so I'm going to meet with him now.
Discovered this thing called the Orb of Power, and I absorbed all of its magic, so now I have all this magical ability.
Oh? You know, I've never actually seen that in real time. I've just read about it. Would you mind maybe showing me?
Yeah, I can show you. Watch this.
How are you doing that?
It's the orb. So I need you to tell me what to do about it.
Okay, Wow, where did you obtain this? Where did you find it?
Let's just say it found me.
Interesting. You know, I've been doing research on this for an extensive period of time, and you know, I want to show you something.
Okay.
Follow me real quick.
Okay.
Let me show you something real quick. See, now this is what I've been researching, and I actually, a lot of this is my own writing.
Oh.
Yeah, I've done like.
Good job.
Extensive. I mean, I've been on this for, you know, several years.
Okay.
Let's see. And what you, I think what you're explaining to me, what you showed me, is.
Yeah, that's it.
Is that it? Is that what you saw? Is that what you grabbed? Is that what you found?
Yeah.
That explains it.
So can you tell me what this is?
Scientifically, we refer to it as the orb of disorder. And why that is because of how uncontrollable and just, it doesn't have a rhyme or reason. You know, you can't control it.
What is that?
Right, and then, you know, that doesn't
matter. What is that? Okay. You can tell me. Right. I won't tell everybody.
All right, if you insist.
Wow, that looks different.
Yeah, it's the orb of chaos. It is insanely unpredictable, dangerous, and outright mad. All right, this is something you don't want to mess with.
Okay.
Not the one you already have, the orb of disorder, you need to get rid of ASAP. It is uncontrollable. This one.
How do you get rid of
leagues
it?
Leagues above that one. Don't even worry about this one. Do not touch that one. This one. They actually have these like relic containers that you can actually store it into.
Where do you get it?
And it, you know, it'll take the power from you and it'll keep it in a controlled environment.
Where do you get it?
It's treacherous. Very treacherous. They're kept under insane like safety measures. There's traps. I mean, there, you know, there's security and codes, and it's actually in a deep, deep cave in Slovakia.
Okay, well, thank you for this information.
Of course. One more thing, actually. Very critical. If you don't get that orb out of you within the next 60 days, it will consume you, and I mean that. All right, so time is of the essence, right?
Okay, thank you.
Absolutely.
Bye. Do you want to come with me?
Actually, I can actually
you can help
you on this journey. Yes. Do you have a ride?
No.
Okay.
They
left you.
Yeah. So you have to drop me to Slovakia.
That's tough.
Let's go.
All right. I actually have a rally car.
Okay. Let's go.
Okay.
All right.
I see it right there.
Oh yeah.
Nothing to do today. I'm off work. Let's go.
Okay. Thank you. Okay. So.
Go home.
Wait. What are we doing? So whenever we get down there, what you're gonna do is we're gonna drive to where.
This right here is an absolute unit. Off-roading, on-road, you know, mountain trekking, it does not matter. This thing does it all. And it's going to be great for our Slovakia trip. And, I got a great deal on it, and that's what we're going to use. All right. So, did you want to go ahead and get out of here?
Yeah, let's go.
All right. Let's do it.
All right. You want to get smoothies on the way?
That sounds good.
Okay.
Let's get out. Sun's going down, we need to get inside. We'll stay here for the night, and then we'll begin our journey, or continue our journey, tomorrow.
Okay. This is my room, and that's yours.
Okay, well, I'll see you tomorrow morning.
Alright, sun's coming up, we gotta get going. Time is of the essence. Do you wanna get another smoothie?
No.
Okay, let's go.
Finally, some good news. Okay, I found the girl I've been looking for. Her name is Sky, and she just had a meeting with this guy named Kevin Baxter. So I'm gonna go ahead and go up to their camera and see if I can see what they're saying. Okay. Dang it. This camera doesn't have any audio. It's okay, because I am a master at lip reading. So this is what they said. Oh no, my dog is in trouble. That don't seem right. Well, it also goes on to say, paper is bad for the environment, and I stink very bad. Okay. So, according to that information, it's not very good information. Wait a minute, what is this? Oh, look at that. The computer has a translate button. That would help. Oh, okay. They're going to Slovakia. Well, if that's the case, I have a plan for that. I have a couple plans, actually. Since the drone didn't really work the first time, try again. But, you know what they say, have a backup plan. So what I'll do is, I'll put a sign on my house, right there, saying, help wanted, but it's gonna be evil help. That way, I can attract people, all kinds of evil people, and I'm sure I'll find somebody really good. And that person will help me stop her. Basically, what could go wrong? I'll see you in Slovakia. So far, I've had 3 contestants down, and none of them were very good at all. But I have this other guy coming in named Dr. Fred, and he's supposed to be pretty good, you know, for what I'm paying at least. So we'll try him out tomorrow. I got this VR thing set up, and it'll be pretty good. We'll try it out.
Evil help wanted.
Another contestant. So, you're here to learn about evil. Yes. What kind of skills do you have?
I have Kung Fu.
Kung Fu? Oh my goodness. Okay, hang on. Before you go crazy, I gotta give you a test just to prove that you are good at the wear. Here, you can just set your hat right there. Okay. This is a VR training center thing, and this will show how good you are at fighting. Okay, so put this on, and stand right here. Okay? Now I'll upload the simulator.
Okay.
Okay. Now, in order to beat this level, you're gonna have to beat the guys.
Yes.
So.
Okay, let's get on.
Ready? Oh, you got 2 of them already. Oh, here comes another one. Whoa, look out. You're doing good so far. Oh, you died.
Okay.
That was good though. That was good. Round 2, are you ready?
Mm-hmm.
And go. Okay, get ready, get ready. You're about to throw. Look out, get him. Oh, get him, get him, get him. Oh, you're doing good. You got him.
Okay.
You beat that level. Good job. Okay. I can use you as a henchman. You passed the test. Good job. All right. This right here is your target. Her name is Sky. And she is heading to Sokovia right now to obtain this relic because she absorbs the orb of power.
Yes.
So what I want you to do is go to Slovakia and stop her by any means necessary. I want you to kill her, take the power, whatever you gotta do, but I want you to get her, all right?
Okay, I'll do my Kung Fu Blast Super Mallet.
All right, let's do it.
Bumper to bumper. It's been like this for about 5 hours now. How much longer do we have to go?
We still got a good 8 hours until we're there.
Okay, so Kevin Baxter is asleep in the car. I'm not gonna wake him because I don't feel like it. But I decided to stop here at this pizza place and eat. He just talks all the time, so I needed some space alone. Hello. Okay, thank you. My table's ready. I gotta go. Kevin, get out of here. I can't believe it. He ruined everything. I guess Kevin decided to join me after all.
The smell of the pizza really woke me up.
This pizza is really good.
Extraordinary. Yeah. Very good. I like it.
here. Wow, there sure is a bunch of cows in Slovakia.
Okay, so we made it to Slovakia. And Kevin is down in the field because he said that I could just stand around and watch his car until he got back because he wanted to do some stuff. So I'm just waiting on him at the moment. Hello? Hello? Yeah. Okay. Awesome. All right, so he said he knew where the cave was, so we're just gonna go down there to where the cave entrance is. So let's go. Uh-oh. I think I hear something. Oh my gosh, it's a drone. It's coming! I got some bad news for you. So your truck blew up. Yeah, don't cry about it. It's okay. So basically, we'll have to get a new one. Oh, what was that? Oh, you found the entrance to the cave? Okay, you're gonna send me the address to it? All right, sounds good. Well, while I do that, you can go find a new truck. You have to. Okay, bye.
Hello? Bad news. What is it? My truck. It blew up. What? Yeah, you think? Of course I'm gonna have to get a new truck. Oh my god. Anyways, I found the entrance to the cave. Yeah. Yeah, well, I gotta go. I'll see you.
Are you joking me right now? Now I gotta get a new truck.
Man, I remember buying that truck like it was yesterday.
Another victory for the rally car. This is the last season though for it. I think I'm retiring. So what I'm gonna do is, I got all this money. The first person that walks by, I'm giving them the keys.
Well, it looks like I'm done for the racing season. I haven't seen anybody around yet. Hello, who are you? Did you just walk in my house?
The door was just open. I thought I let myself in.
Well, it's your lucky day because I said the first person I see, I'm gonna give the keys, and you're the first person I see. So here's the keys. This is my rally truck. It's a monster truck.
Just walking to a random stranger's house. Like a key to a monster truck?
Yes. I'm retiring. Goodbye. Oh yeah, you can leave if you want.
Let's take a moment to remember it. Alright, mom's over. I gotta get in your truck.
Okay, so it looks like it's about 5 miles from here, but I cannot walk that far. So I'm gonna have to see if I can find some sort of transportation. But I do remember Kevin telling me that they had golf carts that you could rent. So I think I'm just gonna go see if there's any that I can rent. And then we can take that to the cave. And then we'll find what we need. Alright, so Slovakia is a small little country and you can ride golf carts on the road. So since our mode of transportation got destroyed, we're going to have to find a new ride. So I'm going to rent a golf cart for now. I'm going to go this way and see if they have any. So I made a deal with this guy to rent this golf cart for one day. So hopefully that should be enough to get me to the cave and back. And Kevin Baxter, I'll just meet up with him later.
The cave is just a little bit on this road, and then after that, it's off-roading. So, in order to get to the cave, I'm just gonna run down this road a little bit, and then I'm gonna go off the road. The gravel road starts right here. Just a little bit of gravel. And then it's full off-road. A little bumpy. Okay, so it's time for me to go off-roading. So this is gonna be a really bumpy and wild ride, so please hang on. Everything that Paul's can tell. Gotta watch your head too because the trees are really low. Alright. Hold on, people. Here comes the hill of doom. Gosh, that was crazy. Wow. Oh my god. Woo! Alright, glad we made it out of that. Not the hill. The cave is only a few miles up the road, so don't worry. We'll be there momentarily. There are literally no restaurants down here, so I'm going to ask this man's house if he has anything that I can eat before I go to the cave. Thank you. Well, he gave me this box of crackers, so I guess that'll just have to do. Don't have time to eat right now. I'll eat them later. The entrance to the cave is right over here. I made it towards the entrance of the cave, so I'm gonna check it out. Okay, so the cave is down there over there, but I already went over there and I'm too small, so I have to wait here till I figure out what to do. Dang it, I cannot believe that we can't get into the cave because it's too small. Hey you, yes. What's your name?
Destiny Flex.
Okay, so you look pretty small and nimble. What can you do?
I can do this. And I can walk. And I can do this.
Whoa. Well, that's pretty good. That's pretty flexible. I'm actually looking for somebody that I need to use their skills like that to get into a cave. So do you think you'd be interested in that?
Yes, only if you pay me though.
Okay, fine. I'll pay you $1.
I'm sorry, that's not enough. What about $3,000?
How about two?
Let's meet in the middle and we'll call it $200.
Okay, great. Thank you.
You're welcome. Now, when do I need to meet you at this cave thingy, and where is the address?
So we'll go tomorrow morning, 9 a.m. meet there, and the address is 301 Highway Tower.
Okay, that sounds good to me.
Okay, see you there.
Goodbye. Oh, what's your name?
Sky.
Okay, Sky. I'm very excited to be working with you.
Okay,
bye.
Me too. Bye. Alright, so now we got her. So we're going to meet there tomorrow morning, and this time I'll just get some sleep for tonight. So, we made a plan. I got my friend Destiny to help me. She's flexible. She can get into the cave. I can't. So, therefore, she can get it for me. Once we get the... Excuse me, who are you?
I am Dr. Fred.
Well, what do you want?
I want the... Help me!
Help me! Help me! Help! Come on, Destiny! This way! This way! Get inside so he can't get us. Hello. So this is the cave right here that you're going to need to be going through. It's the Cave of Wonders.
It's really small and tight.
Yeah.
Think I'm going to fit?
Yes. And okay. In order to see inside, I'm going to...
All right. I'm almost there. I see something. Wow! This is amazing! Oh no! The cave's starting to rattle. I need to get out of here quick. Oh no, a dog! Ow!
Whew, that was a close one. Thank goodness I'm all right.
Okay, so what did you get?
Well, here's your flashlight back.
Okay, thank
it's
you.
It's kind of broken. It doesn't work anymore. Because a rock broke it. Sorry about that. But this is your gun.
Oh, okay.
I don't know what it's for. It's really mysterious.
Let's try it out.
Whoa. Oh. This is cool.
Okay, what should we do?
What are you going to do with it?
This is what I need, purple.
What's the purple used for?
Because my orb is purple. So this is gonna correlate with my orb, and I need to put it in here. All right, let me try to suck it out of me. Oh, it's not working.
I think you need to talk to that guy that you were talking to that's kind of crazy and has the funny glasses.
Oh yeah, Kevin Baxter.
Yeah.
He threw away his glasses yesterday. But I will go talk to him again. Thank you for the help.
Money?
Oh, I don't have any. You can have this.
Wow, a phone. I always wanted a phone. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Money would have been better, but I like a phone. Goodbye.
Bye.
I enjoy doing business with you.
Yes. Another day, another sleigh. Dr. Mario!
You big!
Go.
I will get my drone to attack you!
Phew, glad that he's gone. Now I gotta go talk to Kevin Baxter.
That didn't work out.
In case you're wondering, no. Dr. Mario or Dr. Fred, whatever that guy's name was, it's not dead. He's just unconscious and, you know, probably won't help me again for a good bit. Anyway, on to the next matter. At least, for the good news, I did blow up that rally car they had, which was a pretty cool car, and I was kind of sad to blow it up. But, you know, they had it, so I had to do that. It is what it is. They understand. They probably don't. But never mind. Doesn't matter. The thing is, I'm going to have to come out with another plan. Since for some odd reason, the drone don't work. The henchman guy didn't work. Even with the orb of power drone, for some reason, she's just like a snake slithering around me. What am I going to do? What if I, I'm gonna have to use the orb on her. I don't want to have to use it, but I probably will end up having to use it. I do have it stashed away here. The orb of chaos I'm referring to, of course. If you weren't paying attention. So, I'm gonna have to do it fast though. I have to do it, stop her, and then get the gun, and then absorb both of the powers before I die. Probably won't have very long, so I have to make it really quick. I guess we'll see what happens.
Now I got the gun. I just stored it away under the golf cart for safekeeping, but I need to go back to Kevin Baxter now and meet up with him. He should have his rental cart, but I'm going to return my golf cart first since I only have it for one day.
Okay, so I'm going to return the golf cart now. Uh-oh.
Looks like the tree's down. Guess I'm going to have to find another way. Let's see. So I can go right here.
Swamp? I think I'm lost. Huh.
Like driving
glad I made it out of there. All right, now I need to go return this key to the golf cart man. I guess I'll just have to walk away to go meet up with Kevin Baxter at the rental car place.
I guess it's my job to find a mode of transportation for us to get home. We ain't got nothing else. It done blew us up. Swaki has got to have somebody selling some kind of car here. You'd have to imagine. I'll look this way.
Man, it's been a slow business day today. I've only saw about 3 stolen cars. Well, good luck. Here comes somebody. Let's see what they got going on. I'm gonna get them back.
Man, I swear there was a sign that said there were used cars here, but I don't see any. Oh, that's a truck right here. I wonder who's selling.
Hey, you looking to sell or you looking to buy? I got you a good discount right here. You want to buy another truck? There's none around. This is it.
Hey,
so you looking to buy?
Yeah, I need something to get around, man. My other car got blew up.
Is that right?
Yeah. How much
this thing right here is beauty. Looks like I get through everything. All right. Man. This is the best area you're going to get around here, all right? Don't even worry about where I got it. You don't have to worry about that, all right, man?
That sounds kind of shady, man.
Don't worry about that. It's not shady. This is perfectly legit. Did you not see the sign out there?
Yeah, it
said for sale signs, all right? Did you hear that?
It did say
used
cars. Legit.
I got a paper wrap. It's in the truck, but I'm not going to get it because you don't need that. Don't worry about that.
All right. Well, how much are you trying to sell this for?
How much is that?
I got $6?
Alright, I'll take it. Bye.
Oh, finally. I'm not even gonna question that.
This thing looks pretty good, $6.
I wonder why it was so quick to get rid of.
Yeah, I don't care.
Well, I guess it's time to go back and that I got my new whip. Meet up with Sky. Sounds right. Oh, wait. Gotta get through some gravel before we get there. Oh, man, some grass, too. Oh, it's gonna be a little off-roading time. Well, let's test it, I guess. Whew.
Yeah, I'll wait.
All
Hey, wait, I heard you had some engine problems.
Aren't you the same guy who sold me this truck?
Yes, and I'm also a great mechanic. And I can fix your truck for you for a really cheap price. It's not even gonna cost you hardly nothing. It's the best deal you're gonna get around, man. All right, it's the best deal. You can't beat it. So go ahead and pop that hood and let's see what you got.
Well, buddy, what do you think it could be?
All right, so you see here, these Toyota Tacomas, they always have the same kind of problems. Now, using my advanced knowledge of mechanical skills, I can tell you exactly what's wrong with this big old beauty right here. Mm. You see, the issue is, sometimes there's this little radiator part right here, and it just falls off. Like, it's kind of insane. They fall off all the time. I can't tell you how many customers have called me and said, hey, it's not working, and it's because that part fell off. Well, luckily for you, I just keep this part with me all the time, because it falls off a lot, and usually makes the engine not run.
That's convenient.
Yes, it is. Very convenient. So, I'll go ahead and put this back on for you. Right here.
Hmm.
Okay? There. Now your part's back on. Your engine's gonna run like a beauty.
It works now.
But then, okay. So I know that you don't have any money with you because I gave you $6. But I also take debit because I am that advanced.
And how much would you take off this?
$30.
I'm gonna trust you to give it back to me.
And as a down payment to make sure I give your debit card, how much does this have on it?
I think like $1,000.
$1,000, okay. Just to make sure, I'll give it back to you. I'll give you this really expensive, nice watch as a down payment that I found.
Hey, this is $2.
That I bought. No, it's not. Okay, well, thank you for your gift card.
It's Dollar Tree. What? And he's gone. Okay. I think I just got duped. That's great. Well, there goes my debit card.
All right. Well, I think it's time. And I think you all know what we've been waiting for. Here it is, the War of Chaos. Now, obviously, this is a lot more powerful than the Orb of Disorder. So I'm not gonna be able to just put my hand on it like Sky did and then just get the power, because it would just kill me. It's just too much power to handle. So I have to do something a little different. What I can do is I can find some kind of object around my house, something, and I can kind of like contain like part of its might, put the stress of the power into that relic so that I don't have to take it all myself, and that way I can still have the power flowing through me and have it and then have the object at the same time. So what I'm gonna do is, I know this guy that I've been researching on the internet. His name is Dr. Brad Kiner, the world-renowned fixer. It's kind of a long name. But I'm going to use him to figure out how to contain this power, because he does all kinds of like fixes and knowledges all about these relics and objects. So I'm going to go ahead and call him right now, and we'll see if he can come over and check on my orb. All right. Let's see. Here we go. Here he is. You can see. Let's see if he picks up. Hello. Is this Dr. Brad Kiner, the world-renowned fixer?
Yes. This is Dr. Brad Kiner, the world-renowned fixer. How may I help you?
Well, that's good, because I have this problem here with this little glowy object, relic, called the orb. And what I need you to do is see if you can come over and find a way of containing its power.
I'll be right there.
All right, I'll be waiting for you at the front porch whenever you get here.
Oh.
All right, so there we go. So he's coming, and We'll get this power contained. No more messing around. We gotta get her. We gotta get her now. This will be the end of it. Not too much longer. And I'll have both powers in my possession. It's time to get it done.
Dr. Brad Kiner, the world-renowned fixer, is here to fix your orb.
Is anybody home?
Ah, yes. Dr. Kiner.
Kiner?
Dr. Kiner, I mean, my bad. The world-renowned fixer of all the things that need fixing. So, I called you here today because I have this power called the Orb of Chaos. And what I need you to do is see if you can possibly contain its magnificent power in some sort of object or relic in any means.
Okay. Object? Mm-hmm. Power?
Yes.
Chaos. Sounds like my ex-wife. We can do it.
All right. So, Dr. Brad Kindly, the world-renowned...
Kiner!
The world-renowned economist.
Mm-hmm.
It'd be right this way to my letter, sir. So... I have the Orb of Power stashed right up in here.
Mm-hmm.
And the Orb of Chaos is really going to need a strong object to contain its might. Yep. Here we are. This is the stupid lair that is my lair.
What kind of lair is this?
It's the bedroom lair.
About low budget.
It is a low budget. So, Dr. Brad Kindly, the world-renowned exorcist.
Philanthropist.
Philanthropist. Economist. And socialist.
What
here is the Orb of Chaos.
Well, okay.
And this.
Wait. I got. Hold on.
What do you think we should use to contain the Orb of Chaos's magnificent power?
Let me see. Well, according to my many years of research at the Research Academy,
right.
I have learned this one distinct thing, that if there's anything that can hold this orb, it's going to have to be a metallic object that has a volume of containment for a power such as this.
Okay.
So is there any kind of thing that just goes off in your head that kind of fits that description?
Like a pow kind of a thing?
What's a pow kind of a thing? What's that?
Like some sort of pistol, maybe.
Pistol?
Gun. With gunpowder.
You conservative? Yes, that can work.
All right. Yeah, I think I do have something that I could use.
Nice gun.
Thank you.
What?
All right.
Hand me the gun.
Okay.
Come on. The orbit. Let's go. Go grab me a cable, meet me outside.
Cable, got it.
All right, so what do we do? All right, I have the cord connected from the orbit to the gun to the pad, which will initiate this transaction of power from the orb to the gun.
Okay.
Now, what you need to do is you need to take the orb, take the gun, put them together.
Okay.
Do not have your hand on the orb.
All right,
here goes nothing, I guess.
Are you okay?
Never been better. Oh yeah, I'm ready to get her.
Okay, so this is where I have to meet Kevin at for his new truck. So I'll just wait up here for him.
All right, let's just get this guy. And... Whoa, that's a tree. That right there do be a tree, of course, naturally. Awesome. Hello? Hey, Sky, I was on my way, but, you know, trees are kind of hard to get by, so, yeah, there's a tree in my way. I'm only 3 miles away, so, you know, I would have been there in, you know, like 4 minutes, but like I said, there's a tree in my way, so if you want to meet me here, that'd be fine. All right, awesome. All right, bye.
So this is the gun that I just got from the cave, and I gotta figure out how it works. But first, I met here, because this is where Kevin told me to meet him. So he hasn't been here in a while, so I'm just gonna call him. Hello? Where are you? Oh no. We're stuck with a tree down? But you're only 3 miles away? Okay, I think I can just meet you there. Okay, bye. Alright, I gotta meet him. So I gotta figure something out. Okay, Kevin, I'll be right there. Thank you, bye. I'm sorry, what, where are you again? Okay, I'll go there. Whoa, what's that noise? Do you hear something? Oh my gosh, how'd you get here?
Stop, Sky. I'm here to take what's rightfully mine. You now can... give me the power or I'll kill you.
Never.
Hey, come back.
Oh my gosh, I gotta go. Well, I'll just take this full out of this.
Full way. Where are you going? No, I got a tire flat. Come back here.
Oh my gosh. Sign
quick, come on, get in, hurry, hurry.
No, Kevin. No, dang it. This guy just got away with Kevin. How did they get away? Okay. I'm not letting them get away from me anymore. This is the last time. I can't believe I lost him just because of the stupid flat tire. I did hear, however, that Sky had a conversation with Kevin right before I got here. So, I'm gonna go back to the lair and see if I figure out what they're saying. Alright, I'm off.
Quick, get in! Get in, hurry! He's coming, hurry,
oh
get in!
Oh my goodness!
Hurry!
We gotta get out of here!
We gotta get out of here!
Go!
This should be good. We should be able to show here for a minute. I think we've lost him for now.
Okay, I got the gun.
Is that it?
Yep.
Okay. Why have you used it yet?
It's not working.
It's not working.
No.
What the heck? Okay. I know a guy. The fixer is what they call him. I'll be able to take that to him. In the meantime. Let's get you to that hideout so you can chill there.
Okay.
Alright, you should be able to stay here. I'm going to talk to the fixer. You just chill here. Nobody should be able to find you here. You're safe.
Thank Good day. You.
Hey, Fixer, is he here? Or?
Fixer?
Yeah.
Nah, he's not here right now. He'll be here pretty soon. What you need?
I don't know if you better help me. I need help fixing this.
Fixing that?
It's been jamming and it just hasn't been working correctly. And so I'm hoping somebody can help me out with that.
This doesn't take bullets. How does this work?
It's confidential. I'd rather not say.
Well.
I just hope someone can fix it. I mean, but if you know nothing about it.
Well, I think I can fix it. But how much money you got?
$20.
$20, huh?
Yeah.
All right, I'll make you a deal. I'll fix the gun for $20.
Yeah.
You put down the deposit plan on one of my guns.
All right, I can do that.
All right.
I suppose I'll have to borrow some money, but I can make it work.
Let me show you what I got. First up, we got the original classic blow dart, all right? Needles, pin nails, whatever you want to put in there. Poison, injection. It's good for stealth, stuff like that. It's kind of low class, though. Next, we got the Uzi with a shoulder pad clip. That'll do a lot of damage to you.
Are any of these guns loaded?
No, this one's not. It's Next up, we have the M16 Colt pistol, alright? And that will do a lot of damage. I'll put a hole in somebody. AK-47. You got the auto and you got the single shot. Adjustable sights.
That's gonna do some damage, right?
Oh yeah. It's got the shoulder pad option extras. We also have this police baton that I found.
Oh yeah, but you take someone to the knees with it.
You might need that one day. It's got an electric stabilizer on the bottom, so whenever you're trapping people, it doesn't come back. And then we have, finally, the AK-47 Special Edition.
Ooh.
Now this is a really good one. This is one of my favorites, probably. I really like this one.
That one looks nice.
This will do a lot of damage to some people.
Oh, I want. Ooh,
It's got a giant mag and extended, so you can really mow down some people. All right, which one would you like?
I want to call him a name, man.
This one?
Call him a name.
It's a good choice, sir.
I hear.
I'll put you down for a deposit of an unknown figure that I will give to you later. I need that gun. I'll have this fixed in 20 minutes. I know what I'm doing. Let me get my tools.
Okay. That looks nice.
Mm-hmm.
So the soot calibration was off. If you can see now, it's in the green with 28. You see that 28?
Uh-huh.
Before it was only on like 5. It wasn't producing the right amount. So whatever you were trying to get into this, sell my business, it would never would have worked. It didn't have enough juice and power. It's been sitting for a long time, whatever it is. But now it should be good to go. So there you go.
Man, I got this thing fixed. And I got me a new gun. Today is a good day, let me tell you.
Alright, so the payment is once a month, and it will last for up to 16 months, depending on how much you put down. And if you do not deliver on time, I got a couple guys, and they will come up to your house, and they'll check what you got. That's what happens when you're in the gun market, alright?
Alright, I mean, that's understandable. Gotcha.
Well,
I'm good on my word.
We'll see, alright. So the fixer, he's about to be here pretty soon. I'll let you know that you stopped by. Good day.
All right, man. Appreciate doing business with you.
You too.
All right, got my guns. Everything's set. Gotta meet up with Scott.
Hey, this is Dr. Brad Kiner, the world-renowned fixer. And you know that doctor friend of yours? Yes, that's him. Yeah, he just showed up a minute ago. And I just want to let you know, just in case you want to do a little poppity pop. And if you choose to do so, I mean, you can go and come on now, because, I mean, he's getting away. So just hurry up, all right? Oh, God bless you, too. Yes, all right, bye. What a life.
I hear you. And I have my camera already. So where did Kevin Baxter go?
Oh, Kevin? Oh, my boy Kev, he went that way.
He went that way?
Yeah, you know, near his lab, you know.
Right there? Oh, I see him. Yes.
Wait, how you doing that?
Zoom.
Oh, like the new kids nowadays. Mm.
Yes, just like the new kids.
Yeah.
Well, I'll follow him back to his secret hideout.
Like the stalker, yes.
Yes, like a typical stalker.
Yes, okay.
So he's getting away, so I better leave soon. Before I go, can you take any guns?
Yes. Matter of fact, he took this very gun.
That one?
Yes, that one.
The one in your hand?
Yes, the one in my hand.
So he took the gun that you're...
Did I stutter? He took the gun that's in my hand.
He took that gun right there.
Look, who's up your elders now? No, give me that one. Oh my god.
Well, at least with him out of the way, we won't have any witnesses. So, this is the gun he took. Don't make no sense. Obviously, he's got a copy. Alright. I'm gone. Teleport over there. I see him. Here he comes now. I see him. That's right, leading me to your secret hideout.
Alright, I made it. I got this bad boy fixed. Should be working properly now, I think. There it is. Okay, it's working. Now I just need to go to the hideout and meet up with Scott. And then we'll get this. I'll give this to him and we'll be good. Alright, I'm here. This is the hideout. I gotta figure out where's Scott at.
Should be here. God, there you are.
Oh, hey, Kevin.
I got the gun fixed for you.
Okay.
I talked to the fixer. We worked out a deal. I might need to take your money. That's besides the point. Anyways, I got it fixed, and it should work, and we should be able to do this.
Okay, let's try it out. It's working. I got it out.
Whoa. Did it work?
Yeah.
Yeah.
You feel different?
Yep.
That's insane. I wouldn't, yeah, I'd just leave it there. It might be unstable. I wouldn't even mess with it.
Yeah.
Important thing is we got it out.
All right, so I think we got it taken care of. Wait, you say that? Who is that?
Who the heck is that?
Pizza delivery. We can't have a pizza delivery.
You order a pizza?
No, I didn't order it.
Yeah, or a pizza. How do you make pizza?
Aha! It's me!
What?
Put your hands up. I gave you the power. Where is it? Ah, there's the gun. It looks like you already got the power out of it. I think I'll be taking that.
No, you can't take it.
Not on my watch. Is he dead?
Oh,
I'm back. Oh, alright, it's your time to die.
No.
I'll be taking the power.
No, Kevin, I can't believe that he's dead. I'm gonna kill him. I can't believe it. Oh my gosh. I can't believe that he got Kevin. That's the last straw. I'm stopping him before anybody else gets hurt. And I know exactly where to find him. Going to get him. I'm here to stop him. This is the weapon that I'm going to use to shoot him, to kill him. Stop a secret weapon. I'm taking over the world. Let's go.
I've been waiting for so long for these powers, and I finally have them. Now, I can absorb myself with both the powers and become the most powerful person in the world. How am I going to do it? I've been researching the staff of Hindu, and it has the power to obtain both relics, not just one, but both of them, and keep the person stable without exploding. All I need is the amplifier, the orb power itself, and both the powers, which are absorbed in here. Time to hook my computer up and get it set up.
Everything's ready. It's complete. I have the guns hooked up to the amplifier, which will connect to the staff, which would make it the most powerful weapon in the world. There's one more thing left. The orb. Now, we'll transfer both of the powers into one orb, and the amplifier will push it into the staff, making it unstoppable. Who's gonna stop me now?
Where are you? I'm coming for you!
Alright, with the program initiative and everything set up, it's time to go ahead and start. Now it's time to go grab the staff and become all powerful.
It's worked.
Coming to get you. Uh-oh. What do we have here? Do not enter. Evil science in progress. Smiley face. That's a little on the nose. Well, let's see what it's happening about.
Now that I have the staff of Hindu, no one can stop me. I'm invincible.
Not so
what?
Fast.
What are you doing?
I'm stopping you.
Aha! I have bulletproof. You cannot stop
me. Oh
staff.
My gosh, I can't believe
now,
it.
Now feel the power of the staff before.
Give me
I
that staff.
Give hey, give me. No.
Oh.
What have you done? You have separated the staff. It is now it will explode.
I'm out of here.
Curse you. Nothing happened. Oh. I guess I'm alright.
That was close. Okay. Now that I've saved the world, let's take the time to remember Kevin and all the stuff that he's done for us.
gonna get money. So that way I can build myself a new house since mine blew up. Now that I've saved the world, there's nothing to do. Wonder what other adventure I will get into.